Jesus. What is all of this?
He's got video feeds, recording decks, a mixer big enough for countless mics.
He's watching everything.
It's more than that. He's got utilities running through here, hydraulics, electrics, everything. He can control the whole building from here.
How far down does it go?
This all connects. This is how he's getting around the house. Charlie would say this guy is a fractured psyche, that he's wearing a mask to put what he's doing on a different personality.
That's probably just him. Take a look at this. What is that?
The guy we saw murdered.
Was it set up?
There was no groundskeeper.
But we saw a guy in a yellow jacket with our stuff.
I guess that was Mr. Demet.
I think it's a mistake to say he's just crazy. He is in full control of what he's doing. He's just not wired like the rest of us.
That's not crazy.
He's been tracking us since we arrived. Mark was last seen in the basement. Crazy implies out of control. Look at this place. This is methodical. That's not crazy. No. Wait, he's wearing the mask as part of the performance. At best, maybe he's insecure about something and it gives him confidence.
Insecure? Like, low self-esteem?
Chicago Police! Mr. Monday, this is Chicago Police. Can you open the door, please? Mr. Monday, I'm Officer Stanley with Chicago Police Department. Can you hear me, sir? Agent Monday? Fuck! Dispatch, this is Officer Stanley. I need assistance at 8 West 50th Street, requesting immediate backup. I'm in Agent Monday's apartment. There's blood everywhere and a body. I need immediate support. I think...
Bad parenting can definitely be a factor, but it could be a shitty dad just as much, or an uncle, any adult figure, really. Don't you read any of our research?
I just set up the lights.
I'm sure he fits the profile. Bullied as a kid, unchecked anger. As an adult, he's either an extreme overachiever or a cipher. Nothing between. He likes being in a position of power, especially over women.
Okay, cool, but why? Lots of people put up with that stuff and don't turn into killers.
Aside from the unhealthy obsession with H.H. Holmes, he's copying the M.O. Clearly, he identifies with Holmes somehow. Can we use this gear to find a way out? Maybe we can open those shutters in the lobby. What is this?
Hi, Mr. Monday. This is Lucinda Price from Twilight Prairie Care Home. I tried to call you a couple of times. I understand that you're making voice recordings of your mother, and we do believe in supporting relatives, and of course, you want to capture those precious memories. But
over here.
Look at this. It's all his little tricks of moving walls and crap.
Nothing in this shitbox is real. He controls everything from here. It's a murder factory.
You're right. We should use this against him.
I want to find Mark, not play Demet's game.
If we trap him, we can look for Mark without looking over our shoulders the whole time. Okay, look. He's in here, right? So we get him to go down this hall, and we trap him between these two moving walls. There's no other way out of there. He'd be stuck.
Okay. But how do you make sure he goes down that hall to begin with? One of us is going to have
to be bait.
No, no way. It's too risky, Jamie.
So is letting him run free. I'd say that's more dangerous. Come on.
There's no second chances here.
It's my plan. I'll be the bait.
If you're sure, just... If it looks like it's going south, get the hell out of there.
No argument here.
You could use that as a weapon if need be.
I'm gonna hang on to it. I'm more likely to need it. Okay. That's enough of a moment. Let's do this.
Stick to the plan.
Obviously.
So how do we get out?
Third floor must be a work in progress. Okay, be ready. You're gonna have to time it right to trap him and not me. All right. Here goes nothing. Head down the hall, keep to the right. Was this on the map? More rooms being built. Huh. Shit!
What is it?
A button. There's a reverse symbol on it.
What does it?
Shit, no!
He's making you choose which one of us dies.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Oh, fuck this. I'm not playing this game. I can't do this. I won't kill you. Jamie? I'm not doing it. I'm not playing this game. Tell everyone I chose this, Kate. And if you get the chance to fuck Demet up, do it. Promise me.
I promise.
No, fuck.
Jamie! Thank you. Thank you.
Survive, Kate.
What an excruciating way to go. Jamie wouldn't press the button. She chose to spare Kate at the cost of her own life. Admirable. People can surprise you sometimes. Jamie chose not to save Erin when she could, leaving her to die, deprived of oxygen, suffocating to death. Did the hint I gave you earlier help? Perhaps you'd like another. Let's see if Sir Arthur can help us. This is from The Man with the Twisted Lip. Have you read it? You should. A trusty comrade is always of use, and a chronicler still more so. I think that last bit might refer to me. You should get back. I hope these chats are helpful. I certainly wouldn't want them to be intimidating. I'll be watching your progress, as always, watching very closely.
Come on. I owe you.
Come on.
Hear that? Fuck!
off me! Baby! Run! Stay away from me. Move your ass, Kate. Get up.
I can't.
It's not optional. He's coming. Let's go. Run. Don't stop. Are you okay?
I'm in one piece. Only way out is through. This is gross.
What was that book you lent me?
Navigating the Maze of Anxiety?
Yeah, well, I could sure use that now.
You know it wasn't about mazes.
Yeah, I got that bit.
Look, I don't want it to come across as if I thought you had a problem. Just sometimes when I'm going through a shitty time, I just assume that everyone else is too.
I know. It was good.
You read it?
Yeah. Read all of it, actually.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I mean, not much of a plot, you know. Not much character development, but some good stuff in there. It helped.
Good. I'm glad. I gave a copy to Charlie, but I don't think he's got round to opening it yet.
Maybe we can get this thing working.
morning, Chicago. We begin today with some breaking news. Chicago police today confirmed the body of a man found in a fire at an abandoned warehouse in the Fulton River District to be that of missing FBI agent Hector Munday. Munday has been identified as the Shoeshine Killer, whose recent killing spree struck fear into the hearts of locals in and around Chicago. A spokesperson for Chicago PD confirmed Munday murdered four victims, including yesterday evening police officer Patrick Stanley, a dedicated veteran of 22 years. The fire was brought under control shortly before 5 a.m. this morning. The body recovered at the scene was burnt beyond recognition, but police identified Munday from dental records.
What are those things? Please don't do this!
Jesus.
What's that? Yeah.